What is up mga ka-LifeFit? Welcome back to the channel. This is Denmark. Welcome to a new episode about accessories sa gym. Alright, so these are my 5 most recommended accessories that you can use para to improve your performance in the gym. Just a caveat mga ka-LifeFit, this is just my recommendations. You might have your own set of accessories that you prefer to use. Pero I came up with this list for almost so many years of using them, and proven siya on my side na it really helped me in my own performance in lifting in the gym. So let's check it out. This episode is brought to you by Paras Catering and Events. Check out their FB page and see all the excellent customer feedback regarding their delicious food, great service, and elegant styling. You can reach them at 0917-844-4470 and look for Ms. Jubian Paras. Accessory number one is the weight lifting belt. Ako, I was introduced to this accessory way back before I started. When I just was starting to lift, kasi nakikita ko yung mga kasabayan ko, mga malalaking nagji-gym, so they were wearing this oversized belts. Akala ko pang pantalon lang, so it came in all sorts of sizes and variations. So una kong mga nakita yung mga made of leather, may mga buckle, tapos may mga neoprene weightlifting belts, and yung mga medyo social, yung mga lever belts, yung may slap-on lever belt buckle, yun. Weightlifting belts, for me, is an essential accessory kasi it protects your core and it gives you a stable foundation whenever you're lifting from the ground up or you're coming from a point of you need to exert a lot of effort. And you need to really focus your lifting energy to lift the weight. Chances are kasi pag wala kang weightlifting belt, medyo shaky yung core mo, yung foundation mo. And chances are magkakaroon ng mga energy leaks as the energy goes up through your kinetic chain. I think I discussed this nung season 1, yung covering energy leaks. Kasi nga, yung one continuous flow of kinetic energy through your posterior chain is very essential para maging efficient yung pagbubuhat nyo. So, saan ginagamit yung weightlifting belt? So, the most common uses are when you're squatting, when you're deadlifting, and also when you're doing rows or practically anything that involves your body being on a bent position na medyo kinakailangan ng stability, especially with your lower back. Kasi nga, imagine nyo mga ka-LifeFit, your upper body and your lower body, paano sila mag-work together, di ba? Kung mahina yung gitna niya, yung core. Yung belt, it wraps around your torso para it keeps your spine from moving left to right. So, steady lang siya. Pag kasi nagbubuhat ka ng mabigat especially, you need your energy to just go up and down your spine. Hindi yung napupunta siya sa kung kusan-saan direction, di ba? So, that weightlifting belt ensures na your energy goes through from your lower body to your upper body and vice versa, efficiently. And also, most importantly, it provides a sturdy protection for your lower back. We have leather types, we have neoprene, we have synthetic plastic in a way. It just depends on your preference. Ako, ever since I never did like using leather weightlifting belts. Sorry sa mga fans noon, pero ako, for me kasi parang katagalan tumitigas kasi, nagiging brittle. So when you you put it on, medyo ano na eh, medyo mahirap na. Mahirap nang ikabit. Neoprene naman, usually Velcro ang ano na eh, ang pang-fasten noon, so hindi siya buckle. Ang nakita ko lang na challenge for those is kapag lumaki ka na, medyo hindi na ganun kaganda yung kapit nung Velcro. I have a video of me squatting. Tapos nandun yun sa isa sa mga episodes ko in season 1. I was squatting tapos biglang natanggal yung belt ko. Yung pala yung Velcro, yung pagkakadikit ng Velcro. Ano na, hindi na siya makapit. I think that the upside lang din ng using a leather belt, I think for me mas maano yun, mas sturdy yun kasi nga mas matigas yung leather kaysa sa ano sa neoprene weightlifting belt. Again, on the downside naman, katagalan, nagiging brittle yung mga leather belts and kadalasan medyo stinky sila kasi nga pag yung pawis kumapit na and nag-accumulate na sa isang leather belt yun. Medyo hindi na nagiging maganda yung amoy. Lalo na for public gyms na hindi naglilinis ng mga weightlifting belt nila na leather, yun, medyo hindi maganda yung amoy niya. And syempre, hygiene-wise, hindi rin siya tama. Doon naman maganda ang neoprene kasi they're washable. So, pwede siyang ano, pwede mo siyang banuan para at least lagi siyang ano, mabango at hindi nangangasim mga kalayfit. So, yun. Well, I guess it still boils down to your preference. Pero for me right now, I have a go-to weightlifting belt na which is made of synthetic plastic na may foam sa likod niya. So when I strap it on, malambot pa rin siya and at the same time it still provides the sturdy feel of a weightlifting belt. Accessory number 2, mga ka-LifeFit, is the wrist strap. I've been using a lot of wrist straps for the past years pero siguro yung pinaka nagustuhan kong wrist strap is yung one that has a ano thumb sling kasi nga mas sturdy yung ano, mas nagiging sturdy yung pagkakakapit ng wrist strap nyo. Ako, I think I mentioned this again in season 1. I'm not really a great advocate for using gym gloves to cover your hands, especially when you're lifting. Kasi napansin ko over the years, hindi ganun kalakas yung grip ko, yung gripping strength ko. So, that's because I started out lifting na lagi ako naka gym gloves. So, parang over the years, nung totally nag-bare hand na ako, yeah, totoo, kumapal yung kalyo ko sa kamay. Pero, what it gave me is a much stronger grip. Mas nahawakan ko yung barbell or dumbbell ng mabuti. And, in the end, mas nalilift ko ng mas efficiently and mas maganda yung performance ko whenever I go bare-handed. In lieu of using gym gloves, napansin ko na mas okay yung meron kang wrist straps kasi, again, same thing with the weightlifting belt. It provides stability in your wrists. Lalo na when you're doing, ano, you're doing pressing movements as you go up or when you're lifting dumbbells from your sides or doing curls. Mas nagiging ano, stable yung wrist mo kasi nga, there's a strap that's covering the wrist para hindi lumabas yung energy. So, walang energy leak mga kalayfit. Mas maganda yung hawak nyo sa dumbbell or sa barbell and you can be assured na yung wrist mo is not ano, is not prone to break kapag may buhat kang mabigat on your hands. Again, napansin ko rin na pag nagli-lift kasi dapat yung forehand mo and yung hand mo they're aligned eh. So pag mubuhat ka, the weight should be standing or sitting here in the middle of your hand and your wrist. Imagine niyo pag nandito siya. So it's providing ano unnecessary tension or strain sa ano niyo, sa hands niyo. And yung wrist strap niyo will again play an important role para hindi mangyari 'yon, para at least kahit papaano nandito siya sa sentro. Ang effect noon mga ka-LifeFit pag hindi tayo aware where we put the center of the weight is usually may mga symptoms yan like yung tendonitis which ako nagkaroon na ako for so many times nagkaroon ako ng elbow tendonitis and I had to go through physical therapy and dry needling procedure para totally matanggal yung nafi-feel kong yun yung nafi-feel kong ano elbow tendonitis. So wrist straps are actually very cheap. There's a lot of ano, there's a lot of choices out there. Pero for me, what worked is yung medyo makapal. Makapal yung width. Again, para to provide a much more larger area of coverage dito sa forearm mo. And again, the bigger the ano, the bigger the area, the more it can, the more area it can ano, it can protect mga kalay fit. So yun, instead of using gym gloves, try looking for the best wrist straps that you can use in your lifting, mga kalay fit. Accessory number 3, mga kalay fit, is the lifting straps. Okay. Mukha siyang ano, mukha siyang taekwondo belt sa unang tingin, pero maliit lang siya. Well, actually maraming klase naman 'yun eh. Ang lifting strap is actually just a simple strap lang na you rotate around your wrist. Tapos meron siyang dangling part na yung dangling part na yun, yun yung i-wrap around mo sa bar. Anong purpose nun? Madalas kasi kaya pa nating i-pull yung barbell sa isang exercise. For example, a barbell row o kaya a deadlift, either the conventional deadlift or on a Smith machine. Kaya you're doing a lat pull down. As your arms are going down, you're pulling down the bar. O kaya pag nasa pull-up bar ka and you're hanging there, di ba? Maganda na meron kang lifting strap kasi kapag bumigay yung grip mo, which eventually is bibigay din talaga, because no one is superhuman para forever kang nakahawak and nakagrip sa bar, darating yung point na mag-give way yung mga fingers natin. And hindi na natin mapupull or we will eventually give out. Yung lifting straps give you that additional additional time or additional period para magawa mo pa rin yung exercise. Which is very essential kasi studies say na yung last reps of a set, yun yung usually pinaka-importante kasi that's when the muscle fibers are being effectively damage in preparation for growth, di ba? And recovery. So, parang ano yung, kumbaga kung hanggang 10 ka lang sa pull-ups, pag naka-lifting straps ka, pag naka-straps kang ganun, pwede ka pa siguro umabot na hanggang 15. Dahil, na-give out na yung fingers mo, pero nakasabit ka pa rin dun sa bar. Magagawa mo pa rin yung exercise. And that's what matters in almost all the exercises that we do in the gym, yung last few reps. Kasi if you can still push yourself to do more reps, then all the better, di ba? And the lifting straps is one of those accessories that will help you to do just that, to give you those last extra reps. Ako, hindi ako nasanay na gumamit noon, pero once I was able to use them, yung, well, for me, I could say that for my rack pulls. Dati, siguro nakakadalawa lang ako or tatlo lang ako sa rack pull na 400 pounds, di ba? Pero when I used the lifting strap, siguro maabot ako ng 5 or 6. Kahit dalawa lang yung dumagdag ko, that's very very significant na yun, mga kalayfit. Had I not used those lifting straps, siguro hanggang tatlo or apat lang ako. Di ba? So, give them a try, mga kalayfit. It may change or really improve your lifting performance. Accessory number 4, mga kalayfit, is tapos na tayo sa upper body, balik tayo sa lower body, and yun yung sa knee. So, knee straps. Kung mapansin nyo, those are very long straps na ano siya, elastic siya. May purpose yung elasticity niya eh. Ako, personally, when I put them on, medyo nag-iiba yung mindset ko. Parang may switch na nagsiswitch on sa akin kasi I know pag sinusuot ko na yung mga knee straps ko, I'm in for a fight kasi magbubuhat na ako ng mabigat. Either magsusquat ako ng mabigat or mag-leg press ako ng mabigat. So, ganun lagi yung feeling ko kapag naka-knee strap ako. So, again, it really helped me a lot to push more weight with my legs kasi nga the added elasticity kapag binalot mo na siya dun sa ano mo, sa knee mo, kapag naglalakad ka upright, it's very stiff, para siyang naka secure na gano'n. Pero when you're down there and you're gonna bend your knee, feeling mo napaka ano, napaka stable ng knees mo, hindi siya magbabuckle kasi nga nakakapit yung knee straps sa ano mo, sa knees mo, and it gives you some sort of a spring motion, parang may spring yung mga knees mo, kaya nga nabubuhat mo yung ano, yung extra weight na nilalagay mo sa leg press or sa squat. Again, I do not really advise this for beginners kasi again, you must build first your foundational strength before you try to even use this ano, these kinds of accessories kasi nga medyo ano na to, kapag na ano ka na, nandun ka na sa pa-advanced ka na kasi meron ka nang ano eh, meron ka nang na-built na strength foundation para bumuhat ng mas mabigat, diba? And yung paggamit ng knee straps will just give you the additional safety and security na yung knees mo will not buckle during the heavy compound movement. So, before trying this out, make sure meron ka ng foundational strength. If not, go to the basics. Nothing beats ano, mastering the basics first before you advance in your lifting, mga ka-LifeFit.
This episode is brought to you by Waking. Scan my QR code or use my personal link when you shop online or when you buy at any Waking store nationwide. Get a chance to win freebies and discounts from LifeFit 40.
And lastly, mga ka-LifeFit, accessory number 5, though it's not related to lifting, pero I learned the value of this whenever I did my jogging. So it's a weightlifting vest, mga ka-LifeFit. So again, it comes in all forms, shapes, and sizes. Marami rin siyang different weights involved. Pero mostly, yung mga weightlifting vests, they're made up of sand. So, may buhangin siya. And again, yung iba naman, may mga parang nilalagay na mga metal bars para ma-adjust mo rin yung weight. So, the one I'm using is a 50-pound sand weightlifting vest. So, ginagamit ko siya whenever I do my jogging. So, bakit to ano, bakit to naging parang essential siya or naging recommended siya in my list? I've been doing jogging na rin as part of my ano, as part of my routine kasi nga di ba nga 40 years old na ako, mga ka-LifeFit. So aside from doing weightlifting, kinailangan ko na rin mag-jogging ng mas madalas kasi nga to help my heart and overall ano, overall cardiovascular health kasi nga tumatanda na tayo, mga ka-LifeFit. Pero napansin ko, hindi nagiging challenging yung jogging ko kasi nga, siguro, nasanay na rin ako sa pagbubuhat ng mabigat. So, parang, I'm looking for a heavier challenge, literally, whenever I do jogging. So, isang araw, wala lang, naisip ko lang na ilagay ko yung weightlifting vest ko, na which is nabili ko ng ano, nabili ko lang in a store. Baka naman. Hindi ko na sabihin yung name ng store. Hindi. Yun lang, naisip ko lang yun. At first, naglakad lang ako wearing that. So, medyo parang okay, this feels good. Parang ako nagpa-farmer's walk. Na imbes na nagbubuhat ako ng, or nakikarry ako ng kettlebells or dumbbells, I'm literally lifting something on my torso. So, eventually, nasanay ako naglalakad na suit yun. Eventually, nagja-jogging na ako na suit yun. So, it gave me that, ano, it gave me that additional weight challenge. Kumbaga, it's an additional weight on top of my existing body weight. So, mas ano, mas may resistance. So, yung jogging ko, in a way, cardiovascular training na rin siya. And in the same time, lifting na rin siya. Aside from jogging, pwede mo naman siyang gamitin for other exercises like when you do your pull-ups, di ba? When you do your pull-ups, suit mo yun, di ba? O kaya, when you do your biking, pag nag-stationary bike ka, suit mo yung weightlifting vest, so as an additional resistance while you're doing that steady state cardio. So, again, ito, nalaman ko lang ito by accident. So, I think it's one of my highly recommended accessories na you can do para you can up your intensity when you're doing your cardiovascular exercises and also your lifting exercises. So there you have it, mga ka-LifeFit, my 5 recommended accessories that you can use so that you can improve your performance in the gym. Again, itong list of accessories na to is I've been using them for quite some time na rin, for many years na rin, kaya I was able to come up with this list. You might have a different list of your own. I encourage you to share them. Comment on this video para malaman din natin, mga ka-LifeFit, kung ano yung mga accessories that worked for you, para who knows, we might even try them out in an episode din, and let's see ano yung magiging effect din on my own lifting experience, mga ka-LifeFit. So, for more fitness content like this, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel and Facebook page, LifeFit40. Hit the bell button so you will be notified for all future content. A huge shout out to all our sponsors. Check out their links in the description down below. So we will be seeing you on the next episode. Stay safe always, mga ka-LifeFit!
Like and subscribe to LifeFit40.